Legitimate question. Whenever I eat apples or potato products, I sweat a little bit and my nipples get hard. For a second, I thought this was gonna be a very medical question. And then it just took a turn. This is one of my favorite segments I do, but before we start reading and responding to your comments, I wanna ask you a couple of questions. I've seen a few comments of people requesting me to start selling merch. I wanna do that if that's what you're into. I can come up with some pretty funny mug slogans, t-shirt slogans. I can give you a shirt that almost looks like the Scrubs with my logo on it. Donate some of the proceeds to Limitless Tomorrow or some of the other foundations I work with. And the second thing that I've seen is people asking if I have a P.O. box so they can send questions, letters. I've already had some letters sent to my hospital. I just posted on Instagram. It's a really cute drawing by an 11-year-old girl that was just adorable. So if you want one of those, or you want two of those, or you like none of those, leave it down below in the comments. And I hope you enjoyed this week's responding to comments video. Let's get started. All right, whenever I eat apples or potato products, I sweat a little bit and my nipples get hard. Why is that? I love your channel. Officer Moose, awesome username. Your nipples get hard from eating apples or potato products? There's a condition known as oral allergy syndrome, which is not exactly what you're describing, but basically what it is your mouth tingles and it feels like you're having a little bit of allergic reaction when you eat foods with certain triggering proteins. Again, that can happen with apples, bananas, but it has nothing to do with your nipples getting hard. Officer Moose, I don't know if you're turned on by potatoes. You know, as they say, whatever floats your boat, I'm not here to judge. Would you be willing to do a video on the word quiet in the ER? I have heard there is a secret rule and never say, for example, quiet day so far. KSK, you're absolutely right. You never wanna say that it's been a quiet day. You never wanna say it's been a quiet call. For some reason, every time you say that it's been quiet and you're grateful for it, you suddenly get a lot of admissions, emergency situations, rapid responses, code blues. You start running around like a chicken with its head cut Now, I'm not a superstitious guy. I've said the word quiet and I've brushed people off who told me I shouldn't have said it, but I see why it exists. Mirth van der Heide. Hi, I'm 13 years old and recently I saw a video of how you can grow a few inches per week by doing stretches. Is this possible? What you should focus on to grow the tallest possible is eating a healthy, balanced diet, making sure you get enough protein, make sure you're eating your veggies and fruits. I know that sounds like your grandma talking, but it's true. You need those minerals. You need that ability to grow. You need to get enough sleep, because when you sleep well, you actually get a lot of growth hormone released. And when I say a lot, I mean the right amount, so you're not hurting the amount of growth hormone you're getting. And then on top of that, you wanna make sure you're exercising. When you exercise, it boosts your hormones. It boosts your growth hormone. It makes you process food differently. It makes your muscles grow. And all of those things will contribute to your physical appearance, including your height. Two girls were born to the same mother on the same day, at the same time, in the same month and year, and yet they're not twins. How can this be? Okay, give me a second, Teresa. Two girls born to the same mother. The eggs of a mother were artificially inseminated via in vitro fertilization, and they were born by a surrogate. So they were coming from the same mother, even though they were born in different women as different surrogates. That's my medical answer to that question. Is that the answer, you think? Is it normal to talk, or in my case, talk and sing in your sleep? That's pretty cool, Meg. I wonder if you're a good singer in your sleep. Actually, talking in your sleep has a medical term. I'm gonna butcher how to pronounce it. Somniloquy. Somniloquy, I think, is the right way to pronounce it. It is a normal behavior. It's usually a short-lived occurrence. I wouldn't worry about it unless it's causing a disturbance of your sleep cycle. If you occasionally chatter in your sleep, it's not a big deal. Actually, what you should do is you should record it and play it back the next day. I've actually heard of some patients say some pretty R-rated or X-rated stuff in their dreams. So be careful, you might be spilling some secrets to your partner. Robert Mills. I know medical stuff like stethoscope, tongue depressor, and suppository. What do you know about it? I hope everyone knows what a tongue depressor is. People hate those, and I get it, because when people put anything into my mouth, when people put any kind of medical device into my mouth, when people put the dental mold into my mouth, it triggers my gag reflex and I have a huge panic attack. I've said that before. Yes, Robert, you know a lot of medical words. Doc, I'm a disabled vet. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your sacrifice. I've been gaining weight since I retired. What kind of cardio stuff doesn't require full use of the legs?
Oh, Marianne, this is such a good question.
Immediately my head goes to swimming. Whenever I think of low impact exercise that is really good for losing weight, I think of swimming. I assume you can swim without the use of your legs. I think that there might be some flotation aid devices that you can use to help you swim and allow your heart rate to go up. I know you mentioned cardio to lose weight, and while high intensity interval training is great, and you could do that, like I said, by swimming or playing some sports. Do some weight training. I know weight training isn't always related to weight loss, but actually, if you put on muscle on your upper body because you can use your arms, you can burn more calories throughout the day, which will lead to more sustained weight loss. So people that just do cardio all day long have trouble losing weight when they plateau. Michelle Squiddy. Hey Doc, how's Roxy? Haven't seen her in a while. Hope she's good. Michelle, Roxy's amazing. I actually just had her stay at my place for the last 3 weeks because my dad went on vacation to Spain. Super jealous because I didn't get to go. Having Roxy and Bear in my apartment is crazy because they're just on top of each other the whole time. They love playing. I try to share some stuff on Instagram. If you're not following me on Instagram, you should be. It's drspelledout.mike. So definitely follow me on there. I put updates on me, Roxy, and Bear all the time. Is one sleeping position healthier than others? Me, the general rule that I give to my patients is you should sleep in whatever position you feel most comfortable. Now, if you experience pain in a specific position, you should change. If you experience acid reflux or post-nasal drip, there are ways to change your sleeping position. So if you ever feel like you're not getting restful sleep or you wake up feeling sore, that's a good conversation to have with your doctor. Mr. Jason Hammer. Hey, Dr. Mike, can you tell us what you think about weed? Ah, marijuana. Marijuana, hot topic in the press right now. It's getting legalized, it seems like everywhere. In New Jersey, where I practice, it's actually, you're able to prescribe it for a certain number of medical conditions. In New York, they're thinking about legalizing it for recreational use. Is it as bad as something like alcohol? Probably not. But do we have firm research on that? No, not yet. Not talking about marijuana for medical usages. I think marijuana for medical usages should have been researched decades ago. And the fact that we haven't is truly disappointing to me. Now I'm talking about recreational use. Now here's the difference. When you drink alcohol, because it affects so many parts of your body, gives you hangovers, makes you throw up, it functions itself as a deterrent. So it limits how much you can drink and how often you can drink. When you smoke marijuana or you eat an edible, you can really do that for a long period of time, and you can do it multiple days in a row, and it doesn't have much of a deterrent, other than probably, I would say, smell, because a lot of people are turned off by the smell of marijuana, or at least many people that I know are. So the fact that you don't have this deterrent that alcohol has can really make you consume a lot more marijuana than you can alcohol. Also, a lot of people self-medicate with marijuana. They have some social anxieties, and instead of facing their goals, instead of achieving and becoming better people that they can become happier with themselves, they blunt that anxiety by smoking or ingesting marijuana. So do I think marijuana is this horrible, evil thing that people have once said it once was, and I thought it was when I was younger in fifth grade doing DARE and all those other drug programs? It probably isn't. If it's destigmatized and legalized, it probably won't be the gateway drug that we once thought it would be. I think it's on its way to get legalized, but that doesn't mean that it's safe. It doesn't mean that I recommend people do it. I do think it has serious medical harms that do exist that we don't yet even know about because it hasn't been studied properly. My thoughts on marijuana should probably be legalized. Before we start labeling something as evil or amazing, we should get our research behind that. So that's why I'm never gonna tell you marijuana is amazing or marijuana is awful, because I just don't have the research to show otherwise. The big danger with marijuana is young people using it, and it could change the chemistry of your brain and change the development of it. So that's obviously a danger, but we can regulate that. We can control it. There are some pros. There's also some cons. It's about balancing that and getting your science in order before making a decision. I'm still looking at the science. I'm not an expert. I'm looking to improve. So if you have some articles you want me to take a look at, drop them down below in the comments and I'll gladly read them to improve my knowledge on the subject. Why do you wear two watches? Maria, thank God you asked this question. These are not two watches. This is a watch, classical. I love Zenith watches. I have a few of them. I believe a gentleman should always wear a watch. This is a fitness tracker. It's a Fitbit.
This is what I use to track my steps, my heart rate. I do some exercises on a Peloton bike. So I'm not wearing two watches. I wear a fitness tracker and a watch.
Genital herpes. There's no way your username is genital herpes. That's crazy.
Hey Mike, can you watch Cells at Work?
What Cells at Work?
You wanna link it into the comments so I can see what it is. I'm totally down to watch it.
Mahnoor K.
Mahnoor K. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. I'm trying my best. Hey Doc, I was just wondering, how did that become a thing? Keep doing it, it's very cute. So how did this come about? My videographer, Dan Owens, was asking one time for me to make a sound, a transition type sound, so he can move on to another clip or something like that. And I didn't know what to say, so I said, bee whoop. And somehow, bee whoop has now become the thing that I do in my videos, bee whoop. And it just sounds like a cool sound. If you guys want to send me some DMs of you guys going, bee whoop, I will repost them on my Instagram, because I just think it's cool. Thank you for submitting your comments. Keep them coming. And don't forget to click subscribe and the little notification bell, which tells YouTube that you're enjoying this content and want more. And as always, stay happy and healthy. The cow goes moo. I'm gonna create merch with a shirt that just has me going like this that says pee whoop. And people are gonna come up to you on the street and be like, dude, what are you wearing on your shirt?